to the first of two webinars on effective employer engagement in newcomer skills development. This is Webinar 1, Introduction to Employer Engagement Levels. In this first webinar, Introduction to Employer Engagement Levels, we will begin by exploring the value of employer engagement for newcomer serving service provider organizations, or SPOs. This discussion will then set the stage for understanding how employer engagement levels were defined based on the recent research conducted by TRIEC and SRDC, and how SPOs can develop different types of activities in order to build relationships across their employer network. Finally, we will consider some next steps, particularly in terms of how you can better understand your agency's internal capacity, strategic goals, priorities, and objectives when it comes to building relationships with employers. The next webinar will set the stage for planning for engagement with employers. There, we will explore how to put the employer engagement levels into action, and how your agency can use a staged approach to plan to engage effectively with employers. To begin, let's explore the value of employer engagement for SPOs. The objective of this section is to briefly consider why strategically committing an organization's staff time and resources to engaging employers is of value to you, the employment-focused settlement agency. There are two general goals that are likely true of all agencies that seek to support newcomers enter and advance in the Canadian labor market. Typically, employment-related SPO's main stakeholder is its newcomer clients, whom they want to help find quality jobs and access meaningful careers. At the same time, in order to ensure that employers continue to recruit from the newcomer talent pool, SPOs want to ensure that their reasonable labor needs are met. The experience of newcomer clients is strongly linked to the strength of a SPO's relationship with employers. It may sound obvious to say, but the satisfaction of both groups is equally key to a successful employer engagement strategy. The quality of experience either group has with an agency and its staff is directly related to that satisfaction. As our review of activities and engagement levels will later demonstrate, meeting these two goals is not just about hiring and retention, although these are key outcomes. As we will see, other kinds of outcomes, such as training, capacity building, mentorship, and so on, must also be considered. By focusing on these two interrelated goals, which positions both newcomers and employers as clients, we contend that an SPO can better fulfill its mandate. Underlying these goals is the idea that engagement with employers should not be seen as simply transactional. The intent of employer engagement is not simply about achieving a narrow set of results, neither for SPOs nor for employers, but about fostering reciprocal, mutually beneficial relationships that can grow over time. This client service or customer service orientation is an ongoing challenge for every SPO, and can be particularly tricky when dealing with companies that may be focused on short-term results. SPOs will need to negotiate, compromise, and work to build trust within this context in order to prioritize the quality of the relationships being fostered and developed. Just as newcomers need to feel a sense of value and belonging in their relationships with settlement service providers, so too with business leaders and hiring managers. They need to have their hiring and retention challenges, their pain points, acknowledged and addressed by SPO staff. Employers need to feel satisfied that their concerns and priorities are being heard and taken seriously, for example, or that SPOs are committed to shared or common goals and objectives. This may be especially important for leaders of small and medium-sized enterprises, SMEs, who, living in a community they share with both newcomers and settlement agencies, may be more motivated to take on SPO clients in employment opportunities, but who may have less capacity to do so. Cultivating relationships with this group of potential partners and employers may require creative problem-solving and engagement approaches that favor quality over quantity. Some businesses may interpret challenges as immediate threats, such as a need to find workers for positions open right now. SPOs can work to reframe urgent challenges as the result of longer-term or structural issues, such as skills mismatches. Doing so may help encourage businesses to become open to longer-range solutions, such as training to address persistent skills gaps, even while an agency simultaneously supports immediate labor needs. Similarly, SPOs must consider how employment outcomes for their newcomer clients can be made relevant for their business partners. For example, SPOs that can come to understand the economic indicators or other key performance indicators, KPIs, most relevant to the company or the sector they seek to engage, can work to incorporate these into their own performance monitoring and benchmarking and align outcomes for both groups. To recap, helping newcomer clients find meaningful work requires building and deepening engagement with employers. In order to do this well, you and your team will need to build a solid understanding of the context within which an employer is doing business and use strategies and tactics that specifically consider the following: a business's employment needs, interests, and capacity as an organization or enterprise. Your own organizational capacity and staff expertise that enables you to provide employment services within a settlement context. Conditions that are shaping the broader growth or slowdown of the economy. Conditions that are affecting how businesses are or are not hiring, particularly from the communities and clients you support. These final two points, relevant economic conditions and local labor market conditions, are important contextual factors, but are largely out of an SPO's control, as they are related to structural conditions and global factors that extend beyond regions and localities. SPOs have greater influence over the other aspects, employer needs, interest, and capacity, and SPO capacity and expertise, as these are aspects that, through engagement, can be better understood and cultivated over time. Effective engagement can help create richer understanding of needs, boost employer interest, and help justify capacity building for partnership, all while helping build SPO expertise and define SPO priorities and initiatives as well. The key question is, of course, how? Given these goals and these related principles, variables, and contextual factors, where should engagement begin? How can an agency decide what actions and initiatives will work best? Before we explore how the employer engagement levels might help you, take a moment to consider the following questions. How has your agency recently engaged businesses to address workforce challenges or labor needs? What did you do, and how did they employ your clients? What worked and what didn't from that engagement? What tells you, data, research, or evaluation, that things did or didn't work out? Pause the video now to reflect on these questions before continuing to the second half of the webinar, Defining Employer Engagement Levels. Unfortunately, questions about where to start or how to do effective or more effective employer engagement are not easy to answer and are often contingent on an agency's staff and leadership strengths, as well as the characteristics of the sectors and even individual employers. That said, strategies for beginning to answer them are available for review in the SPO guidebook and will be discussed in the second webinar. For now, it's useful to understand that effective employer engagement can encompass different actions at various levels of intensity and involvement, and that each corresponds to certain results and employment outcomes. Low, medium, and high levels of engagement correspond with more or less significant goals and outcomes, as well as with more or less complex associated activities. Low engagement is characterized by an infrequent and more distant relationship between an agency and an employer, usually with only a few persons involved and with little additional investment of time and resources. Medium engagement begins to demonstrate more frequent and more continuous involvement on the part of the employer. High engagement not only indicates a more integrated and coordinated relationship, it signals a valued relationship, one where the employer champions the work of an SPO and openly acknowledges the importance of bringing newcomers and immigrants into their workforce. Before we look at some examples of activities that help characterize each level, it is important to note that although low and medium level activities may seem less demanding and possibly less consequential for engagement because they leverage fewer resources from employers, they can still be important stepping stones for convincing employers to engage with SPOs, and for SPOs to better understand employer needs and their value proposition. In other words, building strong and trusting relations between SPOs and partnering with employers takes time. While SPOs may wish to jump to high engagement strategies, a more cautious and incremental approach may be needed, one where an agency tests the waters of the relationship, perhaps by focusing initially on low and medium engagement actions in order to build trust, improve the quality of experience, and achieve mutually beneficial results. Taking time may be particularly important for engagement with small and medium-sized enterprises, SMEs, where low engagement gains are both more practical and doable, but less likely to help businesses achieve their core objectives. Examples of low engagement activities include SPOs helping amplify employer recruitment efforts by circulating conventional job ads amongst their network of settlement clients. SPOs inviting employers to participate in themed, one-off activities, such as panel discussions or information events, that allow settlement clients greater understanding of the local economy and its employers. As mentioned earlier, what characterizes these as low engagement is the intermittent nature of these actions. They are not necessarily deep or ongoing. Examples of medium engagement activities include SPOs recruiting employers to participate in recurring networking events or job fairs, sessions that allow local business leaders and settlement clients a chance to engage one another face-to-face. SPOs soliciting input from employers in order to improve their services and offerings, either those services directed towards their newcomer clients or those meant for their employer partners, or both. Employers participating in mock or information interviews to help SPO clients build job search skills and gain insights into a workplace, employer sector, or Canadian job market. Employers involving staff and management in mentorship activities for newcomer job seekers and/or incumbents. Unlike low engagement activities, medium engagement activities are more continuous, or at least recurrent, and demand a different degree of commitment and involvement from employers, either in terms of specific financial or non-financial resources, such as time, space, or expertise, but also in terms of personal reputation or social capital of company leadership. Examples of high engagement activities include business leaders sitting on voluntary advisory and governance committees and tables with SPO leadership. Employers support work-integrated learning opportunities for SPO clients. Even after hiring newcomer clients, employers stay engaged through post-hire support activities to support retention and career advancement. Employers actively defining equity, diversity, and inclusion initiatives within their sector, particularly to enhance newcomer participation across the labor market. Employers getting actively involved in informing, designing, and even delivering aspects of technical and skills-based training. Unlike low and medium engagement activities, high engagement activities demonstrate not just ongoing participation, but employer commitment to and even a championing of their partnerships with SPOs and their clients. Such commitment and championing demonstrates an enthusiasm, not only to the business logic of investing in workforce development, but in the inherent value of the experiences, expertise, and diverse perspectives of newcomer and immigrant talent for addressing the needs and priorities of their businesses. Before we recap, take a moment to consider the following questions. What do you currently do to engage employers? What's in your employer engagement repertoire? What are some of your go-to activities? Where do you feel they fit in as either low, medium, or high engagement activities? Where are you missing out? Or which levels would you like to strengthen? Pause the video now to reflect on these questions before continuing to the conclusion of this webinar. Let's quickly summarize what we covered in this webinar. First, We discussed how the dual goals of helping newcomers to find quality jobs and helping employers to meet their talent needs should be seen as mutually supportive. Employer engagement can be particularly helpful when employers feel they need to first address immediate challenges, pain points, as SPOs can help them to become more comfortable with long-range workforce planning, training, and development as the relationship matures. Secondly, we explored how activities of low, medium, and high engagement might offer SPOs a range of activities for strategically approaching employers and targeting their needs. We discussed the importance of agencies understanding and aligning their client-directed work with the priorities of their employer partners. This understanding can help SPOs meet their partners' immediate business needs, while at the same time help to cultivate the possibility for long-range solutions that sustain the core mission of a newcomer-serving employment agency. Finally, we acknowledge that the effort will take time. Although the intent is to build reciprocal and synergistic relations, there may need to be an initial upfront effort from SPOs that feels like a significant investment, but with what only seems to be low engagement returns from employers at first. SPOs are welcome to review the SPO guidebook and begin to explore their goals and strategies for employer engagement. Part 2 of this webinar series will review the stages of planning and development of a more formal employer engagement strategy, and will explore why conducting economic and labor market research can help an SPO better understand which sectors and employers are likeliest to help your clients achieve employment success, how performing an audit of your organizational capacity can help you staff up to developing and implementing effective engagement activities at each level, how defining or refining your organization's value proposition can link your agency's strengths with an employer's needs. Thank you again for attending part 1 of this webinar series.